Hey guys, and welcome to another video. So today we're still on our Villa Intercom series, and today we'll be having two door stations, and they'll be both be able to call the same screen. Okay, so what we call this in the business a sub door station. We'll be adding to the main door station, and this is our little setup here. So this is gonna be our main door station, and this is gonna be our sub, and we've got obviously our screen here. So let me just run through a quick example.
Failed.
Calling failed.
Calling failed,
and the screen is obviously hasn't even been activated yet. So now we're going to go over to IVMS and set this all up, and come back later for a live test. And I'll catch you in a sec. Hey, and now we're on IVMS, and I've added all the devices, but I have not configured them at all. So they've just been given a password. All right, guys. And so first of all, we need to set up the door station. First of all right. So in my experience doing this, I always set up the sub door station first of all before I set up the screen. Okay, but obviously before we do that, we're just going to need to do some time settings. Okay, save that, copy this for later maybe. Set the daylight savings. Okay, that's the time set. And now to add, we can go straight to the adding the door station. We can go to the device manager and we go add. Now when instead of indoor station, we're going to go sub door station. Okay, so it's the same password as usual. And then we take the serial number, IP address, gateway, and it's gonna be floor one, number one. Okay, then we go okay. So as you see here, it's offline, that's perfectly normal. And now if I remember what to do, we have to go over to our sub door station and configure it. Okay, sometimes when you activate a sub door station, it might reboot itself, so that's why it's gone offline. Just give it a second, it's perfectly normal. Yep, still offline, no worries guys. This is just preparing the device to become a sub door station. Let's refresh this, okay. Should be okay now. Not yet. Oh, there we go. Now it should be good. Okay. Okay, as you see here, now we've got completely different settings, okay? Oh. Maybe because I logged on a bit too quick. Let's try again now. There we go, back to normal. Okay, so it's taken the time already from the main door station. Perfect, that means we don't even have to set the time, but you will have to enable daylight savings time. Okay, as usual, same time settings. And then we go to intercom. Intercom. And okay, we go enter in the session settings here. We have to put in the registration password. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and here it's already found the main door station IP is that. Okay, so that all works good, and I don't believe we need to do anything else. So let's add the screen and give it a test, guys. All right, so that looks good to me. So we go back to our door station. Now we can even check to make sure it's configured under the device management where we add the screen. Okay, so let's go to device management, and you see the sub door station is now online. Okay, so pretty straightforward how to do it. And now let's add the screen, which should be easy for you guys now, as you probably done this before. So adding the screen is very easy. Okay, so as usual, go offline. Now we'll go back to, we'll log on to our main screen here. As usual, guys, it takes the time from there, from the door station. Perfect. Just have to set the DST, save, and then we go to the network. Okay, main door station IP is found out. Okay, perfect. So all we have to do is put in the password. Fingers crossed, it should all be working nicely. All right, guys, so we'll go over to live view now. And now if we push either door button, it should ring the screen. All right, so perfect. If you've got a delivery door, something like that, back door. But anyway, let's flip over to live view now and hope it works. Catch you in a sec. All right, so we're on our live view now and let's ring the main door station. Main door station's ringing, perfect. Just give it 1 second, and let's try the sub door station. Yay! All right, guys, so that was my first attempt at doing it. Well, I mean, for the video wise, one take, got it right first go. So I'm pretty happy with that. But as you see now, it's pretty straightforward to add a door station. Got to be a little bit patient, but the setting wise, it's really easy. So, thank you guys for watching this one, and now you should be able to set up, you know, multiple combinations of door stations, hopefully multiple screens as well. So now to get to a few, some more advanced setups coming up soon by using, we're going to be introducing users, and we're going to have fobs and locks and all that stuff. So stay tuned, because now it's starting to get a little bit more tougher. So hopefully catch you in the next video, and take care. See you then. Bye bye.